Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new here. My name is Emily and I make a ton of videos about Salesforce. So today we're going to be going over how to create a report in 2022. These are some of my best performing videos and I thought that it could use an update. So let's go ahead and jump into reports. It should be up here in the top navigation bar, but if you don't see it, like around here, then go ahead and go to the 3x3 and then search for reports. Click on it. It'll take you to exactly this same spot. So from here, you can either go into your folders and edit a current report, or if you want to create a new report, you would go to new report. Then it'll take us to choose the report type. So this is going to be the group or groups of data that you are going to want to report on. So this could be opportunities, this could be leads, contacts. Just to make this simple, I'm going to go with just opportunities. A few things, actually, before we get started into that, I want to show you the difference. We have and we have with. So with those two pieces of language, that will mean different things and different sets of data. So accounts, let's say for example, is just going to be the accounts and any related data with that. That's just one group, one object of data, as we like to call it as admins. And then when we have things like contacts and accounts, those are two objects, two groups of data that we're going to be reporting on. And it will be contacts and accounts. So when you have contacts and accounts, that means that you'll have both sets of data side by side. They may not be related to each other and they may be related to each other, but they will show the relationship if there is one. This is different for accounts with partners. So you will see accounts, but only if they also have partners with them. So it'll filter through both the accounts group of data and the partners group of data and only show the data that conjoins with the two. So that is a brief introduction to report types. Let's go ahead and go into opportunities now and click on it. Sometimes you can double click, but I'll click continue. And here you can see that I only have two opportunities. Because I like to have everything show up and then filter out later what I do and do not need, I'm going to open up some filters. Also, over here, I want to have update preview automatically checked, so that way I can see the changes live that I am making. If this was not checked, and it's by default not checked, then you'd have to save and then run it, and it's just a whole mess. So you want to see what you're doing in live time. All right, I'm going to go to filters. So we have the show me all opportunities, any status, all probability, but this close date is the one that is restricting all of my data. So I'm going to go from the close date field is all time, and then it should open up more for me. Yes. All right. Now that we have this, I am going to narrow down my data. As you can see, we have a lot of columns. These are also called fields in Salesforce. So there are certain fields that I don't really want to see because it's either duplicated or it's empty data. One of these things is the owner role. I don't need to see this for the opportunity. And it's honestly, it's blank. But this might be helpful if you want to group it by the role. So let's say you had a corporate sales team and you had an education sales team. It would be easy to group that by owner role, just so then you could see the different teams and where they're at. But for the purposes of this, I'm going to exit out of there. Other stages, or not stages, columns that I don't need is the account name, because of how our company, this org, amends the opportunity name to show the account name as well. So I don't need to see that. If the opportunity name was something like contract one, contract two, and it didn't have the account, then it would be really helpful for you to have the account name there. Other things that I don't think are important is the fiscal period. I don't really need to see the date or the probability. Age, close date. I'm going to get rid of next step because there's not a lot of data in that column that we can use. And I'm going to keep type. So now let's say we wanted to understand and group by type. This would be really helpful for us to understand how many of our current opportunities are existing customers, how many of them are new customers, how many of them are replacements. As you can see, we have different reasons for everything. So if we wanted to group by that, we would come over here to groups, and we could group by the field is type, or the column is type. And that'll move the field over here, and we'll be able to see that we can group it by that. Other things that we can do that might be helpful is I'm going to summarize the amount here. So I went to the little caret under the amount column, and I just want to summarize it. So what that'll do is it'll show us for each type, now we can see a subtotal and the grand total of everything. So the grand total is about 3.5 mil. And then new customers, 1.5. Existing upgrades is 1.8. And that's a really easy way to see that. We could also add a chart here to be able to visualize it, if that's more helpful for you. It's just this little toggle chart button. Then we can change the chart properties to see it in a different way. So if we wanted to see it in a donut chart, I don't think scatter plot would be useful here, but we can funnel it. We could also have a line chart. But honestly, I think either bar or column is going to be your best bet here. I like how bar looks a little bit better. I'm going to close that, and I'm going to toggle this off, actually. So those are how you would group it. It's being a little funky right now. I'm going to get rid of this group. There we go. And this is how you'd be able to see that. Now let's say that we had other requirements that we wanted to filter down by. Right now we just see all opportunities of all stages. But let's say we wanted to only see any opportunities that were closed one and how much we have closed one in total. So over here in filters, we're going to choose the column to filter by. And this column's name is going to be stage. You could do this for a bunch of different things. It doesn't have to be just a pick list, or it could be amount. I'm going to go to stage and click closed one, apply. And this will show only opportunities that are closed one. And again, we have the subtotal of how many opportunities are closed one. One thing about this, I know this was bigger than the number that we had earlier today, and that brings up a really good point, is that when you're in the editor, this little thing up here is telling me the same thing, but you are seeing a limited number of records. So you may not see all of the number of records in this preview. You will have to save and run. If you have, I want to say it's around a couple thousand opportunities, then you may not see it even when you save and run, and you'll have to export the data and use a different system to report on it. In those cases, I've usually used Tableau if the report viewer and the report editor is not a powerful enough tool. But for your day-to-day, this should be a powerful enough tool. So other things that we can do here is that we can lock this. So what that means is that anyone who comes in to see this cannot change the stage of it. I can unlock it easily and apply, and then that little lock button goes away. All right, one last thing I want to show before we go is how to create buckets. So buckets are a simple-ish tool that allow you to see and create a custom kind of grouping. So one thing that we could use is that we could use this amount field, and we could create a high bucket, a low bucket, and a medium bucket. So I'm going to get rid of, actually no, I'm going to keep closed one, and we can just bucket it. So I clicked on the amount, which is the field or the column that we want to bucket by, and we can bucket this column. I'm going to go, bucket name is going to be high, or just by caps. So this could be a large cap, a small cap, or a large cap. Large cap, small cap, medium cap. There we go. Okay. Let's see. I'm going to have this be low, medium, high, greater than or less than equal to 50,000. Let's go 100,000. And these are just numbers that I'm really making up. This might be different for you. You might have different teams that are over small business, medium business, or enterprise business. I am going to click save. And let's see. Okay, we have the caps over here. As you can see, it is labeled each of these things, and now we can group by caps. So that will show us the different buckets and have each of these grouped by the bucket. So we can see, okay, in our high cap, we have 3 million, we have 500,000, and then we have 130,000. This is a really great way if you don't have a field on the opportunity or whatever object group of data that you're working for that will say, hey, this is going to be a low cap opportunity, medium cap, or high cap. So it creates a quote unquote fake field or column. So then you can group by it and show the different data sets in a whole new way. So to save this, we'll just need to create a name for it. I'm going to say sample opportunity report, and the unique name will auto-populate just so then the system can differentiate. Maybe you have like 5 different sample opportunity reports, but this way the system won't get confused and pull up a different one. We can have report description. This is really helpful if you are making this for other people to use. It would be helpful to put any assumptions or thought processes that you put into, or just a basic description of the report. And then finally, we can choose the folder, and you can have private reports or public reports. I'm just going to keep this in my private reports. But if you wanted to share this with other people, you'd want to put it in the correct folder. I'm going to click save and then run. It'll take us out of the editor into the viewer, and we'll be able to see more data if there was more data to be had. If you want to edit it, you can go ahead and click edit and it'll take you back. Refresh it. Reports do need to be refreshed if any new data comes through. You can edit it in classic, save as, save, subscribe, export, delete, and add to dashboard. So those are all your options. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. This is a part of a greater series I am doing on my channel on Salesforce and reporting in Salesforce. So if you like that, I will leave a playlist in the description down below. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next one.